I went to Haro International Preparatory School, that's at Abeka, around Fadama. And then I went to Holy Child Secondary School. Now, Haro International Preparatory School, I was actually the leader for the cultural dancing and any kind of dance that was supposed to be done in the school. And the interesting thing is that time there was no stage. So, you know, they built, they put tables in one of the classrooms and then we stand there and then, you know, we perform on the table. And it was not bad at all. I was really into the cultural dancing. And then, so when I got to Holy Child School, you know, Holy Child School, you'll be restricted. You cannot go out unless you're in Form 4. But honestly, when I got to Form 1, the second week, they took me out because they wanted me to go and dance for them. That was one of the cultural displays that they needed me to go and do. So during the homeless night, I was nowhere to be found. I was with the seniors at the University of Cape Coast. I was going to dance there. And I'll tell you something interesting that happened that day. Before I left for the program, you know, I was in a house called St. Maria's. And then I told my fellow Form 1 students that, hey, there's this song I want you to sing when it's our turn to sing. And I think most of them came from Accra, but they were Ashantis and Fantis. So I'm being honest, they didn't really understand the Ghana language. So I showed them a song like, sorry to use the word, but you know, I have to sing it. I said they should say, sing it, homo do na bodo, homo do na bodo. Homo do na bodo, homo do na bodo. When they get the scene, see, do na push, but see, do na. They didn't understand what they were going to say. But that's why I told them to go and sing. I'm sorry, my friends. I know some of you be watching. It wasn't my fault. So when they got to the when they got to their tent, they called St. Maria's, and they came. And that time I had returned from the place that I went to, but I didn't join them. So I was hiding some at the back of the assembly hall. And I said, this person shouldn't sing, they should change it, they should turn it around, they should turn. And they went to sing exactly as I taught them. If you want to understand it, I mean, the buttocks, is soft. And the seniors on is bad. And the seniors got angry. And after the program, they followed them to the dormitory and punished them. So when I came back, I told my mates, I didn't tell you to sing it now. I told you to sing it the opposite way. She said, no, Elizabeth. That time I was Elizabeth Agyapong. I was named after my mom, but now I'm Akosua. So when I hear anybody saying Elizabeth, I know it's the old gurus. So back in Holy Child, you can only join either the AFS or the Gunza. That was the club. So I was in the Gunza. I was in the Gunza club. But anytime there's a competition, AFS will come for me and my group and we'll go and dance and always won. So with the music and the dancing, I had it already before I came into music. So my first performance on stage at Art Center, those that were going to support, I mean, were going to back, the backup singers and the instrumentalists, what they were telling me, it was so interesting. They wanted me to take in some strong alcohol that they were taking. So I asked them, what was that for? And they said, when you take it, you'll be able to perform. And I said, no, I'm sorry. I wouldn't take anything. I've performed in front of 6,000 students. You can imagine at the Citadel, in Fanspim, at Disco, Augustine's, Wesley Girls, Fanciman Girls. So there were so many schools that when there's a competition, I performed in front of them. So I wasn't afraid of the crowd. And God, I thank God for that. Because if I had taken that alcohol, Akousa would be sitting here with alcohol here. I would think that whatever I did there that day, I was helped by that alcohol. So I thank God I didn't take it. So anytime I'm on stage and I'm doing my thing, I don't take an alcohol. I don't smoke nothing because I didn't start with it. So that's what happened. Holy Child, I was also the cultural president. And then the normal, as you know, that time, the robot, the braids, the apano, the mezob. Yeah, anytime the latest dance come and I get to school, yeah, I show my girls, I train them new dancing, and then we just perform. So way back in school, I was really into music. I was really into acting before I even came out of school. So luckily for me, when I finished school, my mom said, you are not going to be a musician. I said, yay, I'm in trouble. Because she thought that way back, Some of the musicians were actually alcoholic, some of them smoked, some of them were womanizers, some of the women too, you know. All, they were chasing all sort of men, I'm sorry to use the word, but that was what my mom thought. So she said, my daughter is not going to be a musician. So I had to force my way out. And then I realized that she really loved Nakwa Mbedu songs. Every Saturday, it's like she's having a party in the house. So I went to look for Nana Kwame Mpedu, the first who actually helped me to pave my way to record my album, which my mom actually supported. Nana Mpedu was sweet. He was there to change some of the lyrics, change some of the songs and other things for Akosua Agyapong. And my first time on television, God, I thank God for that. It became a household name with my dancing, with the song that they heard, a young girl with my new head, the hairdo. People go to sound and say, I want Akosua Agyapong. So that hairstyle became my name. So way back in school till now, I started it way back before I became a musician.